For the last 3 months, I switched from my Galaxy flagship phone to a new phone you probably never heard of, for a very good reason. I wanted to protect my eyes, since I recently realized I get eye strain from spending too much time working on YouTube videos. Also, I'm a university professor now, and I have to read a lot, write notes, and make sketches. Therefore, I needed a phone that has a stylus like my Galaxy S25 Ultra. After a lot of research, I got myself a TCL Next Paper 60 Ultra, and for the price of around $400, I think it offers great value. The display of this phone is very unique. The phone uses some LCD multi-layer fusion tech to mimic the look and feel of e-ink displays. When you touch it, there is a paper-like feeling to it as opposed to the glass feeling you get from other phones. The diffusion system does a few things. For one, it reduces the amount of blue light significantly, which is often correlated with disrupting your sleep patterns. Then, it creates a softer and low contrast look that lets the phone show content at very low brightness, tricking your brain into thinking the phone is paper. It also doesn't flicker like typical OLED phones do, which is also linked to eye strain. Also, using colors can generally be distracting for your brain and create addiction. Therefore, this phone introduces three modes that you can activate with the switch button on the side. One of them is the Max Ink mode that basically turns your phone into an e-reader. It turns off notifications and maximizes battery life. I use this mode often when I want to read a book, which is a very enjoyable experience with a massive 7.2-inch display. The other mode is Ink Paper mode, which makes your phone black and white. I don't use this mode often, but what I do use is the Color Paper mode. This mode makes all the colors a bit dull and reduces the saturation and vividness of the phone. I use this in the evenings when I want my brain to start thinking about sleep and rest, and I love that there is a dedicated switch button for all of these modes. The display is also both anti-reflective and anti-fingerprint, and because of that, it does not show any scratches. I've been using this phone for 3 months without a cover, and I don't see a single scratch. The anti-glare feature has one caveat though. It usually works perfectly unless you put light on it exactly at the top of the display, like when it is 1 p.m. and the sun is directly above your head. In my experience, the phone in that situation doesn't work great. The other thing is that the outdoor brightness on the phone is sometimes tricky, and it does jump from time to time. You can also get a stylus with the phone. You can get the official minimalistic case for it that lets you attach the stylus. The case has two parts, and the second part can be used to make your phone look like a notepad, which is cool. The stylus is also very well made. It does in fact understand pressure, so you can draw with it and not only take notes. The Notes app is also rather nice, and I've enjoyed using it so far. The phone has a triple camera system. Considering it only costs around $400, that's an insane value. And surprisingly, the sensor sizes are also decent. The main lens has a sensor size similar to what you get on the iPhone 17 base model. The pictures it takes of faces are soft but sometimes a bit contrasty. Overall, I'm happy with the processing and it does work well. It is not the same league as the iPhone Pro Max or Galaxy Ultra, but in my opinion, it does better than some of the mid-range phones like the Galaxy A series or older iPhones. The telephoto lens is also of decent quality. It is a 3x zoom, and the pictures I took with it have a nice background blur and good colors. They are on the contrasty side for sure, but overall I'm quite happy with the result. You should put this into perspective. None of the three major phone companies, Samsung, Apple, and Google, put a telephoto lens on phones under $500. You can also use the telephoto lens to take telephoto macro shots if that's what you want to do. The ultrawide lens is probably the one they went cheap on, which is totally fair in my opinion. It is only 8 megapixels and the sensor size is also small. It takes okay pictures, but don't expect too much from it. The phone can take 4K 30 frames per second videos. The videos have acceptable processing. It is nothing groundbreaking, but I like how natural and soft it is. I often see phones in this price range overcompensate and over-sharpen the video a lot. It is around Christmas time here, and I was positively surprised by how the camera performed at night. Usually, phones struggle to create the right contrast for night scenes. they either overexpose or underexpose the pictures, but the pictures coming out of the next Paper 60 Ultra were decent and well balanced. Again, you should take into account that the phone is under $500 and you should not expect the same performance as a flagship phone. That said, the phone sometimes doesn't do great in certain situations. There is something called the network effect, where the more people use a product, the better it becomes. That's why more popular phones have better picture processing. They have bigger teams working on it too. And despite the fact that the camera hardware on the next Paper is decent, sometimes the picture doesn't quite turn out the way I want it to. In those moments, I do miss my Galaxy S25 Ultra. Regarding performance, the phone is snappy enough. It is comparable to mid-range phones like the Galaxy A series. It is not the same league as flagship phones with the new Snapdragon or the new Dimensity. It uses a chipset called the MediaTek Dimensity 7400, which gets around 1000 for single core in Geekbench and around 3000 for multi-core. What this means is that it absolutely is fine for day-to-day tasks, but don't expect to play heavy games with it and expect to be less snappy than your latest iPhone. Maybe one more thing I should mention is that the phone has a single fingerprint scanner on the power button. You can also use Face Unlock, and from my experience, both work flawlessly. The operating system of the phone is Android 15, and they promise 3 years of software support, which is great for a mid-range phone. The operating system is very bare-bone. It does have a few AI features on top for Android 15, like there is a slider that you can use to start AI writing assist and some other tools. The battery capacity of the phone is 5200 mAh, which is the same capacity as flagship phones like iPhone 17 Pro Max and Galaxy S25 Ultra. With my usage, I usually have 20 to 30% battery at the end of the day when I'm in the normal mode and not the e-ink mode. That includes 4 to 5 hours of screen on time with a mix of photography, reading, and social media. For example, with the Galaxy S25 Ultra, I was always out of battery by the end of the day. Overall, I am very happy with the phone and I will continue using it. I really do hope that at some point in the future, TCL makes one with the same display and stylus technology, but with even better cameras and a better processor to have a truly flagship experience. I really love how I can change between the e-ink mode and normal mode depending on the situation I am in. And for the price they are offering the phone, it is an unbelievable value for money to protect your eyes. Another phone that I also recommend getting, since it protects your eyes with less flickering, is the OnePlus 15, which is more like a typical phone. If you want to see how OnePlus compares to the Galaxy S25 Ultra, you can watch this video next. Thanks for tuning in to Techmo, and I will see you in the next one.